Hey folks, welcome back to another Poem Master video. So today we have the Looker banner dropping, which as usual we will be pulling for live when that happens. So, I mean, there really isn't too much to talk about here in terms of should you actually spend your, you know, hard-earned free-to-play gems on this unit? The answer is no. No, I mean, there's not much to talk about, right, in terms of the aspect of if you should pull for it. It's a spotlight unit, right? I'm not saying you should never pull for spotlight units. I mean, I think some are deserving, right? But for Looker, probably not, right? Probably not. Again, there's just, like, even if you really, really do want to pull for him, at least you just, like, wait a few more days to see what's coming in the next, you know, second half. There's also a Pokemon Presents coming out soon as well, right? So, we'll have to see what happens, right? But, like, at the moment, there's not really too much reason to pull for Looker. Right, if you do want to talk about, like, even if you are really, really down bad for, like, a poison-type damage dealer, right, unless you just think, oh my god, I need to have a poison-type damage dealer, then okay, I guess I can't stop you, right? If you're a huge Looker fan, I can't stop you either. Also, you should probably go for it if you're, you know, Looker's favorite character or whatever, right? Although, it'd be slightly weird. Someone's favorite Pokemon character is Looker, but anyways, that aside, I'm not shaming anyone. It's fine if you like Looker. It's all right. I think he's all right. But yeah, let's talk a bit about the unit, right? Because, like, again, even if you are going for, like, a poison type damage dealer, right, he's not bad. I would say he's probably overall the best, second best maybe, right, in terms of poison type damage dealers in the game. So, some quick stuff to talk about. His attack stat's not bad, right? His speed stat's actually pretty bad, right? Everything else doesn't matter. And then, yeah, Poison Sting for some reason. You got Dark Hit Plus, max out crit. Poison Jab is your main damage dealing move, which is a relatively low BP 3-gauge move, unfortunately. And then you have your trainer move on the case, raises your attack by 4, raises speed by 2, and then gives you Super Effective up next, right? So you got max crit, plus 4 special attacks, you basically need, you know, plus 2 physical attack. Did I say special attack as physical attack, right? So you just need a support to give you plus 2 physical attack, and then you're basically good to go, right? So, relatively self-sufficient. Moving on into the passives. Got Refreshing Water Guard, which reduces damage when you're attacked by water-type moves, and then restores your HP whenever, the Pokemon takes an action in weather during when it's raining. This is slightly weird because, yeah, you heal when it rains, but also when it rains, you take more damage from water type moves. I don't know. Anyways, moving on, super duper effective 9. That's a 9% multiplier, right, when you're hitting super effective. So he's basically built only to fight super effective stages, right? Because if you take away that super duper effective 9, he is kind of whatever, right? He's, like, off-type. He is very, very much a struggle fest, right? But again, super effective stages, he does actually do relatively well. So, yeah, as your third pass, we have Toxic Chance 2, 30% chance of believing the target poisoned when move targeting bonus is successful. There is one thing I actually really don't like about his kit, which is this stuff, right? This, although not as much, but mainly this and this, right? If you're wondering, well, why? Don't you want to poison the opponent? Right? I mean, especially if you're going to pick up stuff like Virulent Toxin 5 on the grid or Toxic Power 2. Yes and no. I want to badly poison the opponent. I don't want to regularly poison them. So, like, if I were going to run teams, I'd probably just run them with someone who could Toxic the opponent, right? It's probably like a Tangela. It has a guaranteed chance to badly poison the opponent. Which is better than regular poison. Because here's the thing. Most poison type damage dealers in the game actually have relatively low DPS. But it does kind of make up for it with the extra damage the opponents take every turn. Well, if they do attack, right? From the badly poison that they get. So when I'm doing poison type damage, I'm counting in the extra, you know, chip damage that poison. Well, sometimes it's not even chip damage. If you go, like, full HP on the opponent, sometimes they take pretty good damage. They could take, like, 3,000-4,000 damage, you know, in mass mode max HP per, like, poison tick, right? And then especially badly poison that eventually builds up. That could actually amount to some serious, serious damage per turn, right? So I always do count those as well. And obviously, again, badly poison, better than regular poison, right? Especially against poison weak stage, which generally doesn't have too much poison resistance, right? So that is something nice. As for if you want to, like, the damage wise, right? Giovanni does do more, which is slightly funny because he's not a poison type unit. And on top of that, Giovanni does have the poison type max move, which makes up for him not having like a poison type sync move, I kind of feel, right? But Looker is not like that bad either, right? I mean, this is, again, this is not like, if you compare it to like any other type, this is not like great damage. Maybe like Fairy though, because Fairy kind of sucks. Let's see. Yeah, Fairy's pretty down bad too. Their second highest damage dealer is like Annie Lily, whose Moonblast is not very good and also not his main type, like outside of Dialga. Holy. Anyways, yeah, Fairy. Fairy would appreciate some help as well. But anyways, outside of that, right, he does have a relatively nice sync nuke, especially, you know, if you're going with the double down 5. Got Verlin Toxin 5 over here. Actually, what grid did run for these calcs? Okay, so if you really just want to go for like a, you know, master mode, 2k master mode poison weak, just want to quickly just get it out of the way with a EX striker poison, you could, you know, maybe instead pick up double down. Can you afford that? Actually, maybe you could drop Tusk of Power. Wow, you can't afford it. Oh, actually you can, if you just pick up this and then drop these. All right, yeah, that's exactly it. And you just go for like a big sink. Actually, you won't really need super sinker. No. And just go for like one big sink, then sure, I guess, right? Because you keep toxic power then. All right, so something like that. You know, do a bit more damage than what's over here, right? And again, with the super effective up, you should be able to get, you know, you should be able to either one-shot a poison weak, you know, offensive master mode, or get pretty close to one-shotting it. So, I mean, that's the real, like, argument for Looker, really, is just, it's for convenience, right? It's for convenience against poison weak stages. Although, there's also the caveat of, well, there's probably off-type units that do better, right? Which is true. There's a lot of off-type units that do better, right, than poison does on-type generally. But, I mean, it's not a bad option, right? Look, again, this is not something, again, this is, like I mentioned before, this is not something you should pull for regardless. So, it's just like, okay, in the future, if you do pull him, like, when you're trying to pull for, like, some other, you know, limited units or whatever, and then you get him, it's like, all right, oh, that's neat. Okay, that's something I could probably use in the future for, like, poison weak stages. You could, you know, get more copies of them slowly, right? In terms of, like, the grid-wise, he is kind of reliant on grid. 1 out of 5 doesn't really give you anything at all, honestly. So, like, 1 out of 5 is basically just the poison jab DPS. You don't really have any of your sync stuff. 2 out of 5, you do get... Okay, 2 out of 5, you don't get any, like, the good stuff. I guess you do get, like, toxic power, too. You get some, like, really funny stuff, like Water Guard. So what you could actually do, you could run Tank Looker, right? Water Guard here, another Water Guard here. You could Lucky Skill another Water Guard there. You could run, like, Lana on the team for another team Water Guard. And just absolutely tank that, like, the crap out of Water-type moves. So there's that. Fast Track 4 is not bad, right? Fast Track 4 is definitely nice. Attack plus 20 is pretty... you know, something there as well. And then move good refreshment poison jab. And yeah, 3 out of 5, you got stuff like Furious Brawn here, Super Sinker, I guess, double down, Virulent Toxin 5, Catalyst is nice, right? Berserker 2, if you just really don't want to run another support on the team, just want to max it out himself. Then Hostile Environment as well. So yeah, 3 out of 5, you get most of the good stuff, right? Like the actual good stuff. The meme stuff you get at 2 out of 5. The Water Guard meme, but yeah. Yeah, there's really not too much to really talk about him. He's a really convenient unit if you do get him 3 out of 5. You know, EX Striker probably one-shot a full offensive Poison Weak 2K Master Mode. But outside of that, obviously, when you're not fighting Poison Weak stages, he's kind of a potato. But, you know, that's what he's built for, specifically to fight Poison Weak stages. And he does that adequately, right? Again, this is not a mind-blowing next tier level unit that does like anything crazy or new. It's just a nice, comfy versus poison weak unit, right? Which you could use, I guess. So, anyways, if we're gonna give it a pull score, maybe something like a 3.5 out of 10. The reason why it's it's a bit higher than I guess you would expect, considering all the bad things I just said about him, right? I don't even think I was that harsh. I was being relatively fair, right? By the way, it's under 5 out of 10, which under 5 out of 10 in my book would be something that you should not be pulling for. Again, if you are free to play, if you're a whale, then you could do whatever, right? But yeah, like, he has his issues. He's not that great of a unit, but he's just a nice comfort unit. I just gave him like a extra bit of points for like, it's comfortable, easy to set up, right? Especially if you're a bit newer to the game. All you gotta do really is just poison the opponent, max out your offensive stats, and then boom, you go nuke a poison weak stage. Not that crazy powerful of a unit, just a very, very nice comfort unit. So I just gave him a few points for that. If you don't care about comfortability and just want to like off type poison weak stages instead, then it's like, I don't know, 0 out of 10, probably. Okay, so he's not that bad. All right, let's give him at least like a 2 out of 10. Okay, if you don't care about comfortability, but anyways, it's under 5 out of 10, which in my personal suggestion is you probably shouldn't pull for anything out of under 5 out of 10. But again, hey, if you're a Looker fan, if you're a huge Krogunk fan, go for it, right? It's your best chance to get Looker / Krogunk. Well, at least for a while, right? So, but otherwise, yeah, it's something that you could, it's a unit that you could look for in your future summons when you're pulling for limited units to maybe see him pop up in your like multis as a treat. So anyways, that's really this one, I guess. Hope you all remember, guys, think of the comments down below, like, enjoy the videos, or channel for more Pokemon content. We'll be pulling for him later tonight, so stay tuned for that. Have fun, I'll see you guys in the next one.